We know that a very simple and efficient greedy algorithm gives a true approximation for the load balancing problem. An obvious question to ask is whether that analysis is tight. Maybe really that algorithm gives a 1.5 approximation or 1.3 approximation or something even better, and it's just the case that our proof did not manage to give such a better guarantee, but the algorithm in reality really does perform much better. But it's not too difficult to see that essentially the algorithm is tight and we can't really do much better than what the proof is claiming. For example, suppose you have 90 jobs of size 1 and 1 job of size n, and you have 10 machines. Now assume that our greedy algorithm, for whatever reason, decides to consider the jobs of size 1 first, and then at the very end consider the job of size 10. What schedule would it produce? How would it assign the jobs to the machines? It's easily verifiable that the algorithm would evenly spread out all the 90 jobs of size 1 across the 10 machines. So each machine would get 9 of those jobs. And then in the last step, the last job of size 10 is considered. At that point, all 10 machines have a load of 9, so the load of all machines is equal. So no matter where we put that last job, the load of that machine will increase by 10, and we will end up with a final load on that machine of 19. So that will be the make span of the allocation that our greedy algorithm produces. But the optimal solution can do quite a bit better. The optimal solution for this particular input would be to place the job of size 10 on a single machine and then spread out the 90 jobs of size 1 across the 9 remaining machines, giving each of those machines 10 of those small jobs. And you end up with an allocation where each machine has a load of exactly 10. And that is obviously optimal. So while our greedy algorithm produces a make span of 19, there is a solution that produces a make span of 10, giving us a ratio of 1.9 between those two numbers. So the approximation factor cannot really be better than that. And if we use the same construction but with more machines and more jobs, we end up in a scenario where as the more machines we use, the closer our approximation factor gets to 2. So in general, if we have an arbitrary large number of machines, we cannot hope to prove anything for this algorithm beyond an approximation factor of 2. We cannot go below that.